Hi, I'm Christian. Hello and welcome to episode number 6, which is the final one of our second season of Controlix Developer. During the previous episodes, my colleagues and me, we have guided you through a complete pick and place application. We started with the configuration of all the components, then we programmed the control, both with PLC code and our graphical IDE. Then we integrated machine safety, and finally, we created a web-based HMI. To wrap it up, today I'm in our innovation lab to demonstrate you an entire handling application based on a real machine with a real kinematic. In our first episode, we have shown you how you can intuitively configure all the components with the help of our Controlix configurator. In the background, you can see a typical Cartesian robot for unloading an injection molding machine. This is the first focus application for Controlix automation. But let's have a look into the cabinet. Here, you can see the most compact drive on the market, our Controlix drive. The control system, Controlix Core, is already integrated in one of the drives. So talking about the numbers, this means we have 3 axes, including the control, on only 100 millimeter width. Really unbeatable. To access the machine, I simply take the Ethernet cable and connect it to my PC. And the Controlix Core appears in the Controlix Works environment. That's it. In order to start my web-based configuration, I click on the control and my standard web browser opens. To log in, I always need a username and of course a password to fulfill all the security standards. And here we are on the landing page of the controller. If you now click on Settings and Apps, you will find all the currently installed apps, like the Controlix Motion, the third-party app Node-RED, the oscilloscope, and Controlix PLC. How to install and configure them we have explained in the second episode of this season. Within Controlix Motion, our axis and the kinematic are already configured, so I could move them directly from the web interface. And since I'm connected to a real Cartesian robot, it means if I push the chalk button, the axis will move right away. Now, the initial commissioning is complete, and to program a motion sequence, I can use the IDE app for visual coding. The prepared project includes a typical pick-and-place sequence, starting with the movement into the machine, using a blending functionality for time optimization, grabbing the product, moving upwards to the place position to drop the product there, and it starts all over again. Of course, you can program the same also in a textual way. We explained all of this in the third episode of this season. Now we can start the program and watch the running code and the moving robot at the same time. Okay, let's stop it for now. By the way, how to achieve a high safety level with Controlix Safety, we have shown in episode number 4. Now, let's take a deeper look into the web-based HMI, which can be displayed on any consumer tablet. In our last episode, we demonstrated how you can build your own web-based HMI. Also here, I can easily chalk my robot. I go to the manual menu. I end up in the chalking screen. And with the help of the arrows, I can start the movement right away. For starting a sequence, I just go to automatic mode, activate the 3D view, and start the Python script. Okay. Let's stop it. We were actually moving with the maximum possible speed of the mechanic, which is 1.5 meters per second. I hope you enjoyed the demo of a real application. And that's it for the second season of Controlix Developer. Together, we created a really easy-to-use application on the Controlix core. Thanks for watching. Feel free to ask any question either in the comments or in the Controlix Automation community. If you have missed any of the episodes or a how-to video, you can find the corresponding links in the description below. I'm really looking forward to see you again soon. Until then, catch you in the next season to be two steps ahead.